Hello guys, we're back with another video, and in this video we will take a look at my team, we will take a look at the upgrades I did, and we will take a look at why I did these upgrades, and especially I will show you a new method how you can earn consistently coins. So guys, I hope as always you like the video. If so, then subscribe, tell your friends, comment, like, and I'm sure you know the ladies will love you. And if they don't love you because of this video, maybe you try out one of the strategies from my first videos, from my last videos, beating cover 2, beating prevent. And if anything doesn't help you, then don't panic. I will have another video out today or tomorrow with how to beat the cover 4 out of the gun bunch tight end. So guys, be on the lookout for that. But let's jump straight in today's video. In today's video, we will take a look, as I said, at my team, and I think I did some major upgrades, again, without spending too much coins on that, yes, and not money, that's what I mean, without spending money on that, since we are no money spent team, and you see my coins are down bad. I'm not broke, but yeah, not man rich anymore. But yeah, how I want to change this, we will see this in the end of the video. If we take a look at my team, guys, you see that my first three players are very high. I have Sean Taylor on 93. I have Jalen Ramsey on 95. I have Mike Haynes basically on 94. So it changed a lot since the last time we took a look. So let's go into detail. In the offense, I didn't change that much. I just replaced Allworth for Hushman Zadeh. Yeah, TJ Hushman Zadeh. I hope this is right. And then other than that, I really didn't change anything. What changed since the last update yesterday is that the APs changed, so I'm not able to put more than Gunslinger on Zach Wilson. So I will have to see how this works out without roaming that eye, since it's went up to 2 AP and not 1 AP. The other stuff that I did is put slot, what did I put? I put short in elite on Hushman Zadeh, but that's something that I wanna change. So refund ability, I will put slot-o-matic on him. 800 coins, perfectly, I have 800 trading, I have that. I will put slot-o-matic on him because, yeah, a lot of players run this and it performs better. He gets good routes and better catching on short slot routes or routes from slot, and that's what we are looking for. And he gets, this card gets crazy animations. So yeah. Then what we did here and on the defense side is basically where we improved a lot. So you see we have a lot of players with 94, we have a lot of players with 91, we have some players with 64 here. Yeah, that's why, because we are looking to go with the Raiders to the 50-50 Raiders. So but for this we need some more coins, but yeah, later on we will try to do that, but not for now. So what I did is mainly I bought Mike Haynes and I put everybody into a power up. So I put Jalen Ramsey into a power up, I put Philip Buchanan into a power up, I put Mike Haynes of course into a power up, I put Sean Taylor into a power up, and I changed my Mud Master, my Mud Captain. So I have Jake Youngblood here, so my D-line is okay for now. I have Jake Youngblood, I have Clowney, I have DeForest Buckner for pass rushing purposes, and Lindenwall Joseph for, yeah, run stopping purposes. But if you take a look at, let's say, Mike Haynes, my best corner, then he is a 94 corner, OVR corner, has 94 speed, 93 acceleration, 90 agility, 93 jump, 89 play rec, 92 zone, 93 zone, 92 man coverage, and 92 press. So basically 90 all over the field, 91 change of direction plus, guys, and that's very important. This guy is 6'2", and this means I will play him for a very, very long time. Even after I have a better corner, I will put him on safety, so he will make plays for me for a long time. That's why you should, and that's the tip that I have with team building. If you consider putting someone in a power up, then do this because you think you will have this card for a long time, or this card will get upgrades in the future. And I feel like my Canes could be the card that we had in Namdi the last Madden. And then we have specialist, and I put Jamal James, as you see here. Ed Reed and Jamal Adams. I put them into power ups as well. So let's take a look at this card. Upgrade. Take a look at this card. And Jamal Adams is a 93 speed overall player. And what's the good thing, guys? I have him in the slot. Not in the slot. I have him as linebacker. I switch my defense from 3-3-5 to 3-3-5 wide. And so I have safeties on outside linebacker positions. And you see with Acrobat. And somehow the Acrobat here is not activated. That's what I will change quickly. Let's take a look. Okay, he shows that he's... let's take a look at this guy. This. He shows that he's activated. Okay, I don't have an ability on him. Why? Okay, I have to figure that out later on. But yeah, on the other players, I have abilities. So basically, there we changed nothing. And the biggest change that we made is for sure the strategy card. And this costs a lot, guys. I was a bit lucky to find the cards without paying too much. But yeah, if you remember the last time when we spoke about this, I had something about 1.4 million. The power-ups, the players costed, I would say, at least 400,000 to 500,000 coins. And then I paid again something in between 200,000 to 400,000, maybe 300,000 coins to get these strategy cards. These strategy cards are very, very important because if we take a look at these cards, they add speed to my wide receivers plus one. They add man coverage to my DBs. They add zone coverage to my DBs, play recognition, awareness, and so on and so on. And the good thing is, if you have two of them, and the important thing is, you have to have one stat that is different here. So in my case, this card boosts speed, awareness, play rec, and zone coverage, but it doesn't boost man coverage, but pursuit. And that's the way you should look at it, or that's the card you should search for. In this case, the cards can stack. This means that I get plus two speed on every of my defensive backs, and so that's the awesome part about this, guys. That we can use to really boost our speed, our stats on defense. To be honest, I don't like the strategy cards because you have to get lucky in finding them, and I will show you how. The last year we had Sprinter, but everybody could just buy Sprinter, and you knew which price you had to pay. Today you have to go to the marketplace, go to players, and then you have to buy these cards. So basically this pack says it contains a common or better net strategy item. It means you can get the silver, you can get the green, but you can also get blue ones, the rare ones, and this is basically the best case if you get rares, but it's not doesn't has a high probability that you get this. But if you get that, you should do the following. So let's go into exchange, and then you go into strategy card, and every strategy card that you guys get, you should put it either here, so you get a rare out of it, or you should put it here. What I did is I put my cards here. Why? Because when you try to pull cards out of the set that I showed you, you get a lot of the times you get the green card, and every green card you get makes the amount of coins you need to spend to get to this rare card a bit lower. And so I had a feeling, or every time I did that, I had in between 2 to 3, sometimes even 4 green cards when I pulled 20 or 40 of this silver card. So every time you can get the green card, it makes probable for you to go get cheaper to the rare ones. And if you have the rare ones, if you have 5 greens, you can put them here and get a random rare strategy card. So, and if this random strategy card is not the card you're looking for, then you need 2 of them to put it either here or here, and then you will get the choice of 1 of 10 random rare strategy offensive cards or defensive cards. And that's how I basically got my defensive strategy card. So the next thing that I want to do is to add the same card, but only for wide receivers on my offense, so I can get +2 speed on all of my offensive cards. So guys, you see, it tells 89 OVR, but in reality, we really have a God squad. The only piece really that we are missing right now is Jerry Rice on offense, and maybe Josh Allen. I would go with Josh Allen on quarterback, but other than that, you see, we have a very, very good squad, and we didn't spend a dime on this team. So guys, you you see, it's possible to build a no money spend squad, and trust me, I have a child, I have a wife, I'm working full time, so it's, you don't need to grind the whole day. You just have to be consistent, do your solos, be clever on the market, and try methods. So what I want to try, and I need some coins, some trainings before that. I will do something that you guys shouldn't do, but I will do it just to make it quick. I will quick sell some cards to get up to 150 trainings. So give me the core gold, and then I will do this and this. Then I will do this. Yes, 55 fervor. So I have 150 training, and the method you should use to get more coins, and that's what I will do the next few days to get up to over 1 million, to get man rich again. To get man rich again is, I will go into the marketplace, I will head over to training, and then I will take a look at my base offensive playbooks and my base defensive playbooks. So what you can do here is, if you know which playbooks are going for reasonable amount of money, so I would try to do this base offensive pack. I know that the Raiders went for a bit of money yesterday, and I will buy this pack, and I will then pick the Raiders playbook. Let's go to the Raiders one, then buy it, and then I have bought it basically for 150 training, and depending on the market, you get it for cheap, that means cheaper amounts of coins, or more expensive amount of coins. Currently, I think training goes for 20 coins per training. This means I bought this playbook for 3,000 coins, and if I sell it, let's take a look, 4,000, 5,000. You should try to sell it for, let's say, 5,000 for 5,000 coins. And if you do this, then you basically get 1,500 coins every time you do this. So it's not a crazy amount of coins, but if you do this steadily, and again, there's no risk involved in that, as long as you keep track of the price for training, there's no risk in this method, and you will get easy coins back. You don't have to build sets with five players that you have to snipe, 5 gold players. You directly can buy it, sell it, so sell it very fast. And if I take a look, let's do this at my auctions, you will see that I closed a lot of these ebooks. I closed bills. Just we go over and you see we sold a lot of them. Sometimes you have to sell it for a bit cheaper when the prices are low. So that's another point. Try to find out which times are the best times to sell your ebooks. Sometimes, and that's because of the purpose of the video, I sold ebooks very, very fast just to show you guys that this method works, that you can actually sell stuff and that you can earn money. So I will take a look again if I have some playbooks left here and put them on the market. So 9 playbooks left. Not quick sell, but sell. Go to auction. Here, as you see, this one is the playbook that doesn't go that well, but we still will try to sell it for what for 4,000 coins. Then we will sell some other ravens that we have left. Auction this for 8 hours. This and then do this again. So if we sell this, guys, we will make easy 8,000 coins, 6 to 8,000 coins, and that's basically what we're looking for. So guys, I hope you liked the video. Be on the lookout for the next video. In the next video, we will take a look again at our Gun Bunch tight end scheme, and I will try to show you a way how you can beat Cover 4. So be on the lookout for that. As always, the ladies will love you. I will love you personally if you subscribe, if you tell your friends. So my guy, see you in the next video. Bye bye. Have a nice day.